top 5 Mariana Trench mysteries. The Mariana Trench. This place, located in the Philippine Sea, just off the coast of the Mariana Islands, is the deepest part of the ocean. It's actually so deep that Mount Everest will be completely submerged under 2 kilometers of water if you somehow manage to throw it in there. Naturally, people don't know much about it, but we are here to remedy that. Welcome to Brain Yeti, and today we bring you 5 Mariana Trench mysteries that will blow your mind. Number 5. A place of extreme temperatures. As you go further and further down into the depths of the ocean, the temperature gets steadily colder. It gets especially cold down in the dark and abysmal waters of the Mariana Trench. Temperatures there constantly hover at just above freezing, somewhere between 1 degree Celsius to 4 degrees Celsius. But there are certain parts of the trench that have temperatures on the opposite side of that scale. That is, if you venture close to the hydrothermal vents that litter the trench roughly a mile down in a world where the water is 1 or 2 steps away from turning to ice. There are several vents that shoot out water close to 450 degrees Celsius, otherwise known as black smokers. The water in these vents shoot out tons of minerals that help life in the area survive and thrive. The creatures that call the trench home need these minerals and the energy they produce, as even 1 mile down is too far for the sun to have any effect on them. It's either hang around this super hot water or perish. Quite amazingly, this extremely hot water doesn't boil. This is due to the extremely high pressures down there. Number 4. Presence of high pressure. In a high pressure situation, pressure exerted by water that deep is tremendous, according to scientists down in the trench. You can experience up to 100 times the pressure you would experience at sea level. To put that into perspective, if you can somehow get 100 elephants to stand on your head, you'd get an idea of how much pressure we're talking about there. The pressure is so high that it actually increases the density of water to about 5%. That means if you take a 1-liter bottle of water, then dive down into the trench, by the time you get there, the water in your bottle would be up to 9.5 liters. Such extreme pressure should make it impossible for your life to develop down there. But there are a few creatures that thrive under pressure and make the Mariana Trench their home, one of which might surprise you. Number 3. Clams live there. The intense water pressure down in the trench makes it difficult for anything with a hard shell or bones to survive, hence the abundance of sea cucumbers and giant amoeba. Yes, you heard me right, and we'll get to those later on. If you stuck a turtle down there, it would almost certainly end up crushed by its own shell. And of course, the recent discovery of shelled animals in the trench, such as clams, should put a damper on this little stereotype discovered in early 2012. These clams predominantly reside near serpentine hydrothermal vents. The serpentine rock is rich with life-giving minerals such as hydrogen and methane, which allows life to form around it. Nobody yet knows for sure how the clams evolved their shells to be so sturdy under pressure, and unfortunately, they're not talking. However, water pressure aside, these vents exude another gas, hydrogen sulfide, that is normally lethal to clams and other mollusks. Luckily for them, though, they have evolved the ability to bind the sulfide to harmless proteins, thereby nullifying its toxicity and allowing the deep-sea clam population to survive. Number 2. Presence of bridges. In late 2011, 4 rock bridges were found in the Mariana Trench, stretching from one end to the other, measuring roughly 69 kilometers long. It appears that a meeting of the Pacific and Philippine tectonic plates formed the bridges. The Pacific plate ended up underneath the Philippine plate, and the seamount material that both sides brought along collided into various structures on the other side, turning it into what we see today. One of the bridges, Dutton Ridge, was discovered back in the 1980s, though only in low-res pictures. It certainly helped matters that Dutton Ridge is incredibly tall, almost like a small mountain. At its highest peak, the ridge reaches 2.5 kilometers above the Challenger Deep. Of course, that's still more than 8 kilometers under the water. Researchers' ability to find something in a trench that, up until recently, was a near-complete mystery is truly astounding. Like so many other aspects of the trench, we don't yet know what the purpose of these bridges serve. After all, fish don't need bridges. Number 1. A land of giants. Yes, it's indeed true, giants dwell in the Mariana Trench. But not the ones that you're expecting, like the Megalodon or like a Floridian. Nevertheless, they are equally or maybe even more terrifying. But first, what immediately comes to mind when you'd hear the phrase single-celled organism? If you're like the rest of the world, you'd probably think of microscopic bacteria, and you would be right. That is how nature designed them. However, the design plans might not have reached whoever made these giants that live in the trench. Meet the xenophyophores, the type of amoeba that is 4 inches big. These single-celled organisms have allowed to become so big precisely because of their environment. The cold temperature, high pressure, and lack of sunlight all contribute to this amoeba's relatively nightmarish size. If that's not enough, they also appear to be superhuman, immune to many elements and chemicals that would kill most other species, including our own, by ingesting the minerals and particles in the water. The xenophyophores have developed a tolerance to uranium, mercury, lead, and other things that could kill us if left unchecked. Also, don't think you'd eventually stop seeing those adorable critters the deeper you got. They've been spotted as deep as 10 kilometers down, and scientists would not be surprised to one day find them even deeper than that. Did you enjoy this fact overload? Let us know in the comment sections down below. As always, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Later, everybody.